panel discussion, but we will have a question and answer session because there is more time left. So let me introduce about the topic what we have planned. With new technologies emerging almost every day, business is becoming complex. In such an unexpected business environment, Indian CIOs across industries are bracing up with novel challenges. I was thinking about the constraints in the Indian ICT industry. What are answers that spring to mind? One is the bandwidth growth, budget constraint, and last innovation. We cannot deny the fact that the Indian economy is subject to global slowdown and export market starts doing better and hope the economy will soon get back to higher growth of 6% and thereafter. Moreover, innovation can help us in discovering what opportunities exist now or are likely to emerge in the future. Successful business not only respond to their current customer or organization need, but often anticipate future trends and develop an idea, product or service that allow us to meet the future demand rapidly. So let me introduce to the panel members. May I invite Dr. Harold DeCosta, who is the CIO of Intelligent Quotient Security and is said to be the cyber expert of the country. Dr. Harold DeCosta. Mr. A.C. Tawadia is the CIO of Bombay Stock Exchange. Sir, can I invite? Mr. Mahir Patel, Head Technology and Online Global Stores. Welcome, sir. Mr. Bhaskar B., Regional Director, India SARC Checkpoint. Here we are doing the IT industry, entire IT industry is there. We have a very crucial role of association to run the IT organization. Here I can invite Champak Lal Gujar, Chairman of TAFE. So welcome, sir. So here we are talking about the key trends driving business innovation. So Dr. DeCosta, so you as a cyber expert, what do you think? Do you think innovation is highly necessary for driving the business? What kind of innovation you see? When you find some innovation, what are the challenges you find in the cyber security?
Yeah, innovation definitely is important. As I heard what Mr. Agarwal was saying about e-governance system. And innovation at the end of the day should relate to smart, simple, manageable, accountable, reliable, and transparent. So when you talk about the innovations point of view, it has to be there. And when I talk specifically on the cyber domain, innovation has to go with it. The only thing is that people has to be made aware that how to use the cyberspace. It's almost about 90% and above people who are using the internet domain are actually not knowing that they could become a soft target of cybercrime. But given an awareness point of view, I believe that innovation can help the nation, the citizens, and more or less the people to achieve the communication barriers to become smaller and smaller. So innovation definitely has to be there. And cyber consciousness, it has to be starting from the school level. And I'm sure that with the IT Secretary of Maharashtra State team over here, I think those days also will come very quickly, maybe in a few days down the line. Cyber education more or less has become a mandate as far as the UGC guideline is concerned, that it has to come in all the colleges, graduate, postgraduate colleges, the technical fraternity. So innovations, cyber domain, cyberspace, all are linked together for the benefit of the citizens.
So how is a security company, Bhaskar, how do you address this situation?
I was waiting for, you know, the right time for me to talk. So first of all, threats were very simple those days. Just go back a decade, today it's getting more sophisticated. That's the first idea. So when the bad world is getting innovation, collaborated, and trying to take bigger chunk of a normal citizen or organization, ideally the good world also should collaborate and try to innovate. As you said rightly, change is so important. to take it forward.
You have a big customer, is BSE is there.
Yes.
Yeah.
So be careful.
It's not about being careful.
Okay.
I never say that any company is 100% perfect in security, because threats are evolving, technology and solutions should also evolve. The day threats are, you can say that it's 100%, this is it, then technology can say 100% they're securing it. But I believe in the last few years, at least 3-4 years, I've seen espionages, cyber threats, advanced person, DDoS attacks, or whether it used to be more of personal, now it has become state-sponsored. So keeping that in mind, it is very important when threats can evolve, innovate, solutions and technology also should innovate. I think right selection of vendors and partners is more important.
Mr. Kesi, do you agree with this?
On the innovation piece or the threat piece?
Okay, you can talk as a CIO perspective. Like everybody says that CIOs are the driving force for business innovation. Like, how true is this opinion?
Yeah, today, at least in the stock exchange world, like we always say, we are doing IT, we run IT, but we also do stock exchange business. It's an ancillary thing for us, because for us, everything is technology. If you do not have a technology, stock exchanges today just close down. So for us, having a robust technology and the biggest challenge for us, being the CIO, is to ensure that the integrity of the exchange is paramount. Because today we see, we have a tagline, Sensex is of the world watches. Okay, so that's our brand value. Now, we just cannot dilute anything for the sake of anything, because for us, having IT security is of the topmost priority in any. We get audited almost every quarter by different auditors. It can be from the regulators, it can be from the government agencies, it can be our own internal auditors. And every time an audit happens, there is an IT audit, there is a VAPT audit. So we, in fact, as I speak, like we also have this ISO certification audits. Like we just finished one ISO audit yesterday. We have another auditor who has just come in, and at times we get a lot of irritated. The team gets irritated. They keep on asking me, do you work for the business or do you work for the auditors?
So what innovation do you feel that from auditing?
So the auditing, see, the one is the point is I would like to, if there's a lot of auditors here, because there has to be a commonality of guidelines for the auditors also. Because if I have audited somebody, I have an auditor, if you're trying to put somebody X's report, they said, oh, we want to do our own audit. So at times, when I see, I get, if I feel something I have answered already, but I don't know who I answered. Because the same questions asked by different auditors for the same thing. So we have a multiplicity of audit, which is also our problem.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like a necessary thing that we have to, the only thing is what we are looking for is also, there's an education awareness even from the auditors, like the people who audit. See, there is a big gap between the vendors who provide the solutions, or the thing, the guys who implement the solutions, and the guys who audit the solution. So there is a big gap, I think we have to work out between the things. And that is the area I think people have. So some sort of like awareness or the education of the audits.
Yes, I got your point.
So that is what I'll say has to happen. Because today I think there's a gap, because a lot of X are being put up. But when you come up, like we also have a panel of auditors, when we ask as an exchange, because we have almost 2,000 members, so we have to audit 2,000 members, because ultimately they connect to the exchange.
Yeah.
Now, I know how much challenge it is for us to even train the auditors of how to give their reports to us. Ultimately, every auditor uses his own perception or whatever he understands. So I think the practical IT audit is still a challenge. This today being handled by a lot of CA auditors who just become CISAs and all that. So that's one area I think there is still a big gap in the industry.
So before that, how Mr. Patel, you think about this innovation?
I run two hats for the company. One, I am CIO for my retail organization, which is one of the biggest retail chain in India. And I also run the online e-commerce business. So as a CIO, I think one area is very, very clear that to continue in business, you need to innovate. business today looks at innovation as a pre-criteria, and that has to be delivered very, very quickly. I think, you know, business says that I want this system 2 months or 3 months. And I think one of the very, very important point which I want to look at is that partner that we would choose is especially an Indian company. I think we will not go beyond an IT domain as a situation. So I think that emphasis is more as an IT-driven organization, a business-driven organization looking at an Indian partner. I think that's something which we will look at concentrating rather than not as a feature, as a point of a procedure, but we always lay emphasis as an Indian partner. I think that's as a CIO we look at as an organization. So I think innovation today is a very, very key criteria to look at business transformation. So CIOs get in transformation. But the framework when you innovate has to be within the boundaries. You cannot go beyond the boundaries and look at an innovation which will not be supported very well. Because when you're looking at a customer-facing front-end system, these things are very, very priority. So as a CIO, you look at business first, innovate, and then provide the right solution.
Okay, so Aegis, Mr. Chappak, you are a vendor, you are a distributor, you are also a retailer also. In case you are just doing substantial, how do you address to this situation, like, is innovation?
Last year also I was there in a panel, and there were customers there that the things are changing and we need to change. It is said to be suna chalega to chalde hi tarika hai. In IT industry, if we cross more than 16 years, then you're out. Things are changing so fast. Now, in our industry, hardware industry or in software industry, the thing from desktop to laptop and laptop to now to tablet, things change so fast. There is a war going on between communication and IT. IT is taking communication business and communication taking IT business. We don't know where to go. But at one point of time, if you don't do it, you will not be able to get a market in your hand. Now, 2 days back, my doctor called me that, Chappabhai, I want a tablet. Doctor's asking a tablet for me. So, and a tablet I don't do. And I thought, hey, I should start a business also. My association members should start a business also. That maybe community is not under the company. But no, we need to change this way on. We need to change as the time. And things are changing very fast. The technology, desktop is 100% computing. Tablet is not 100% computing. But things are there. We need to change and come on that. Thanks.
So I understand that many disruptive technologies, including mobility, when you talk about the tablet, so BYOD and big data, etc., are shaping enterprise technology in today's global market. Are you ready for this change as a CIO, sir? One question to you. Talking about BYOD technology, big data, are you ready for the change?
See, I'll just give an example of BSC. Big data is something very buzzword these days. A year back, when we were doing capacity planning for our systems, Linda, we used to do around 4 crores orders in a day. In a 6-hour window, the exchange gets 4 crores orders. That was a year back. And that is the time we were told, can you do what is the capacity planning? And we had taken, if you have to increase the capacity, there are 2 ways. Either you buy more hardware, like when you say horizontal scaling, and the budget was around 50-60 crores worth of additional investments. The challenge was, we really make any revenues by that kind of company. So the other option, innovation, was we thought of. We started doing optimizing the softwares, you know, trying to take out more shoes. And today I can say with pride that with the same hardware, the same configs, we, as today was one of the highest, we're doing 11 crore orders with a percentage utilization of not more than 40% of the capacity utilization. So what we have done is, like, this is also one kind of innovation, whether you call it within the big data framework, and improvisation, like today. And this is again like totally in-house people have developed, and we touch 11 crores orders every day.
So how do you, what will you?
Yeah, I think as an organization, we have adopted these new technologies of cloud and big data quite some time back, and I think it's paid off. When you're looking at a CIO, you know how your business runs, because you are part of the executive committee and you report to the MD CEO, so you know what is the nuts of how the business functions. And when you have to deliver a solution, you very well know which would be the right fit or the best fit. So we looked at, especially on an e-commerce platform that we did almost 2 years back, and we moved on Amazon Shopify platform and looked at developing and implementing the complete software on e-commerce on within two months time frame. So benefits has to be looked at by the CIO. He has to be look and connect in the industry today with the partners today who can make a difference to you. So as a CIO, you connect with your partners who will add on value to your business. I think value is a factor which has to be grown.
So when you talk about the analysts as they're watching it, so we have a very senior analyst also sitting out here. Here we have Pramod Rao also sitting. He runs an organization, Jacob, he's into total security. I think, Mr. Pramod, you are seeing all these things, the challenges you are facing or you can observe from the CIOs, right? So how do you provide the thing at the security point of your vendor?
So though you said disruptive jargons,
yes,
big data, BYOD,
yes,
but I look at it constructive. Things have changed. Okay,
yeah.
Gone are the days where you used to have desktops. Today, organization corporates.
I said, BYOD, there are two definitions, right?
Bring your own
device or bring your own disaster.
So disaster comes when there is always a device.
Yeah.
So you need to have a balance.
Okay.
One is having the right security controls.
Right checkpoint security.
I don't want to now talk about checkpoint.
Okay.
Having the right security controls.
Okay.
And also business continuity.
Okay.
If you don't have the balance, then becomes a disaster. And trends are today after Web 2.0, social networking. Facebook is even crossed 1.3 billion users. It is eventually we have to go with this. As you said, it's disruptive, which I can't digest. Organizations are using whether it's LinkedIn or Twitter or even Facebook. So security, from security perspective, we feel, or I probably would say that there has to be a balance. Having the right security controls in your organization, as well as enabling the business smoothly.
Yeah, here we have a person who has not disclosed his personality. Like he is catching the cyber crimes, cyber criminals, who is already here with us. Okay, do you think security is a very good platform for the business point of view, Mr. Champak?
Definitely, security. You can see that day by day, it's controlling most of the business areas or public areas, and you can see the security will play a very, very important role. I think today in India, the security is only some 1% or 1.5% people are only using it. You can see in future, it will be a very big business, and people will be having its importance for them and compulsion for them to be using security.
When you talk about Bhaskar is touched about the Facebook and LinkedIn, I want you to use one example, because every day you must be having so many things, facing so many things. You give me a live example. Is it by using Facebook, LinkedIn, or safe?
No, it's absolutely not safe. In fact, in Maharashtra alone, you know, if I just look at the statistics of the cyber crimes, 70% of the cyber crimes which are registered are to social networks. And most of these cyber crimes which are registered is actually because of the unawareness of the citizens. And therefore, the cyber crimes grow into a very exponential growth. In fact, one example I would like to share across with, security aspect point of view itself. Just a few months before, I was working on a Mumbai University project, the delivery of the question papers electronically. And at that moment itself, it was very important to ensure that the papers which have been encrypted, digitally signed, and sent to the system has to reach to the every examination center 1 or 1.5 hour before. And also making a point that it should reach the right examination center at the right time, at the right moment. And also keeping a watch to help the Mumbai University officials, the examination department, that the papers are being downloaded at the right examination center. So we delivered a system at the back end where the question papers are exactly getting downloaded, we used to catch the IP address. There were some instances where we found, a couple of instances we found that the question papers were not getting downloaded at the respective examination center, but somewhere out also. And those were being logged out, monitored. And when the respective examination center was asked a question that what you do is exactly monitored, believe me, the system got implemented without any hassles. Fear cycle is the main thing in the mind of the citizens. And once that is put across,
Mr. Agarwal is there, and I had a nice opportunity because being an IT secretary, I had a lot of turbulent times these two semesters with the Mumbai University in having this question papers to electronic consent. But believe me, this time, just few days before when I was interacting with the colleges of PCOM, they came out and saying that you might have implemented with engineering colleges, you might have done with the pharmacy, you might have done with the BA, law, but you can't do with us. I asked them why. They said we are in a rural place where we have got a problem of internet connectivity, so on and so forth. I just asked them three questions. I asked them, do you use mobile phone in your college premises? Everybody said yes. I said, do you have an email ID? 90% said, yes, we have. I said, how many of them are on Facebook? 30% said, we are on Facebook. I said, all this are driven by internet, all this is driven by technology. And where do you run all this? It's only that in your house you use a mobile phone or in your office also. This is an office also. I said, if you use in the office, you have got internet connectivity. And for us to work this system, what we require is the internet. So where is the problem in this? And finally, all the colleges, in fact, not all, most of the colleges at the end of the day said, we will go with it.
So as for you, what is the internet penetration in the country? So much thing is happening.
In fact, I would not know exact statistics of the internet penetration in the
13-15
the
in the country.
Internet users in our country is almost 12 crores.
Oh no, percentage.
It could be much more than that. Much more than that. But internet users in India is almost 12 crores. The internet users. And the penetration of the internet mostly in the young age group. And as I know, one of my friends was just saying across, Facebook mostly is being logged in between 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. It's after the college time or after the official hours, you know. So that's been logged in across. And that's what the information I could get from Facebook or from Google. That this is what actually happening in India, so on and so forth.
Still, Canadian government gets the ATM fraud through the Facebook members.
Yeah, in fact, you know, I asked one of the officials from Facebook that if I delete my profile on Facebook, is my profile gone? He said, for the next 200 years, it will be there with us.
Oh.
So it means to say that, you know, if they archive and keep it with them. I asked them, why do you keep it? He said, because of the law enforcement agency. We never know if any law enforcement agency gets up and asks for information to us. And the IT Act becoming a little strong, I don't know how much actually getting implemented, but becoming a little strong, they have to provide this information. If the server is placed within India, within 36 hours, and if the server is placed outside India, within 45 days. So they said that because of this, we archive and keep this information and give it across to them.
So thank you. We have a very less time, but we hope we could have continued this for the hours. So we do, as a media, we don't have any take. Still, we have to have a conclusion on the panel discussion. What you thought so far is the use of innovation and technology continues to have massive effect on business and society. We are now seeing emerging markets become hotbeds of innovation, especially in efforts to reach the growing middle class and low-income consumers across the country. Executing on exiting strategy and no longer prisoner of business and government must think deeply about the opportunity and risk presented in the evolving trends. Now I thank all the panelists for their valuable inputs. We will continue the discussion during the networking dinner with a great hope. By becoming here, we will have more advanced system of approach for the new approach innovation. Thank you.